Welcome to the Flat Earth Community University Lecture Series. Today, we are proud to present the prestigious Department of Media Studies.
Lies, the cosmos is not an ocean, except beyond the firmament. I mean, that's water, obviously. So I suppose technically, yeah, but listen, it's the first sin and I'm not backing down now. Where is Neil deGrasse Tyson's mustache? What's he not hiding? Anyway, turtlenecks went out of fashion in the 80s. Here's what a real scientist looks like. That water didn't find its level.
The size and age of the cosmos are beyond ordinary human understanding.
If that's the case, then how do you understand it? Here at FECU, our understanding is so limited, you should count yourself lucky that we didn't make the dome the size of our Uncle Roger's trailer.
In the last few millennia, we have made the most astonishing and unexpected discoveries about the cosmos and our place within it.
Speak for yourself. We're still holding out for the first Flat Earth discovery. Any day now.
We wish to pursue the truth no matter where it leads.
It's incorrect to plot a truth course based on a non-flat heading. That's just basic.
We will not be afraid to speculate, but we will be careful to distinguish speculation from fact.
Easy. It's fact when we say it, speculation when other Flat Earth channels say it, and lies when NASA says it. If that's a real spaceship, then where is the toilet? Oh, never mind. There it is.
In the Hercules cluster, the individual galaxies are about 300,000 light years apart. So light takes about 300,000 years to go from one galaxy to another.
False. All years weigh the same. Except for 2006. That was a really heavy year. Wife left me, lost my job, friends mocked me. I drank too much and sank into an emotionally vulnerable state. Coincidentally, that's the year I became a flat earther.
We are approaching what astronomers on Earth call the local group.
Our local group is called Free Bar. They always draw a good crowd on a Friday.
It's a vast storm of stars and gas and dust. As we pass over it, we see one of its small satellite galaxies.
An entire galaxy of satellites. How many of those things do they expect us to believe they launched? I mean, even if you launched one a week since the 50s, there'd only be... Thirty-three!
There may be such intelligences and such starships.
Starships. Actually, they're called yachts, and it's always a lawyer that signs the restraining order, not the star. Trust me, I know.
Some stars are flimsy as a soap bubble. Others are 100 trillion times denser than lead.
He means Eric Dubay and Logan Paul.
The hottest stars are destined to die young.
Don't worry, Orphan Red, you'll live a long time.
Are they also a danger to themselves?
Do they also put corks on the end of their forks? Well, they should. It's just sensible, and I can't believe the globalists don't. Health and safety sin.
The largest planet in our solar system is Jupiter.
If there are huge round planets out there, then why can't you see them with a telescope?
On its dark side, superbolts of lightning illuminate the clouds, as first revealed by the Voyager spacecraft in 1979.
If that were true, the Earth couldn't be flat, so it can't be true. QEP.
There lived a man named Eratosthenes.
It's pronounced
Eratosthenes.
He was an astronomer, historian, geographer, philosopher, poet, theater critic, and mathematician.
Ah yes, we have heard of this in rem of which you speak. We call him Oracle, for he is wise.
Why would anyone lie on such a trivial matter?
Of course they lie. They always lie. Even if they admitted they were lying, I wouldn't believe them.
I've inserted two sticks, or obelisks. One up here in Alexandria, and one down here in Syene.
Wait a minute. Isn't Egypt bigger than that? And where are the pyramids? And the Eiffel Tower? This is a fake Egypt.
Now, if at a certain moment, each stick casts no shadow, no shadow at all, that's perfectly easy to understand, provided the Earth is flat.
And cut. There. He admitted it. Everyone! Everyone! Neil deGrasse Tyson admitted the world is flat! Case closed. They made a statue to Orphan Red. Quick, change the picture before she copyright strikes us.
In Alexandria, there was an immense library and an associated research institute. And in them worked the finest minds in the ancient world.
Not feck you, though, was it? Not a football. Football is part of the conspiracy, you know. Not because they use balls. It's psyops to make us feel bad for dribbling.
It's in the library annex, the Serapeum.
Who is Sarah? And who's this guy she's going to pay? So many questions.
If I could travel back into time, this is the place I would visit. The Library of Alexandria at its height 2,000 years ago.
If I could travel back in time, I'd sail on the maiden voyage of the Titanic. Love that movie. I cry so much each time, I'd never make it to the end.
Here, in an important sense, began the intellectual adventure which has led us into space.
Intellectual adventures lead us into space. So, not rockets then. Gotcha!
It was the first true research institute in the history of the world. And what did they study? They studied everything, the entire cosmos.
How can you research things if there's no YouTube? It's impossible, that's how. Wait, he said the library burned down thousands of years ago. Ah, that explains the ancient fashion. Neil deGrasse Tyson is really Methuselah from the Bible, and he's still alive today. That makes sense now. Sin deducted for historical accuracy.
There was Dionysius of Thrace, the man who defined the parts of speech, nouns, verbs, so on, who did for language, in a way, what Euclid did for geometry.
Yeah, just like Dell.
And there was the astronomer Ptolemy, who compiled much of what today is the pseudoscience of astrology.
Now here we agree. Astrology is a super science. It's amazing what the alignment of the planets in a solar system can tell you about meeting a tall, handsome stranger. And yes, we do believe in the solar system when it suits us. You really don't know how this works, do you?
The organizers of the library combed all the cultures and languages of the world for books.
Now that's advanced academics. I've walked past a few libraries in my days, and the people inside could definitely do with some professional grooming. Wouldn't say books would be a very good payment, though. I mean, you only really need one to measure your height. I've always wondered why they make so many.
We know that there once existed here a book by the astronomer Aristarchus of Samos, who apparently argued that the Earth was one of the planets, that like the other planets, it orbits the sun, and that the stars are enormously far away. All absolutely correct.
Wrong. Everyone thought the world was flat until Columbus. It clearly says so in Washington Irving's fictional story.
Every month is 1.25 billion years long. Each day represents 40 million years. Each second stands for some 500 years of our history.
I know. I was married too. Sin's deducted. Sin's deducted.
The blinking of an eye in the drama of cosmic time.
What is this witchcraft? Burn him!
Down here, the first humans made their debut around 10:30 p.m.
Well, it looks like Dad, but he never got home before closing time. Must be Uncle Roger. That's about the time he'd call round for half an hour to see Mum.
We humans appear on the cosmic calendar so recently that our recorded history occupies only the last few seconds of the last minute of December 31st.
So, recorded history is just the bit where we're sat on the sofa drinking cheap wine on our own in the dark, sobbing.
We on Earth have just awakened to the great oceans of space and time from which we have emerged. We are the legacy of 15 billion years of cosmic evolution. We have a choice. We can enhance life and come to know the universe that made us, or we can squander our 15 billion year heritage in meaningless self-destruction. What happens in the first second of the next cosmic year depends on what we do here and now with our intelligence and our knowledge of the cosmos.
Our choice is to act like there's nothing to see and nothing to know. We will draw a halt to human curiosity, declare ourselves the greatest experts alive, infallible even. We will make our conclusions and handpick our facts to suit them. We shall snuggle under the warm blanket of febrile paranoia, knowing that the cosmos is unfathomably small and we are significant beyond measure. Our world will be controlled by some mysterious, all-powerful shadow government, and we will feel special because we're the only ones that worked it out. While the science advocates look up at the stars, agape in wonder and awe, we will focus on our own self-importance. Come with us and lock the doors of the concrete bunker of ignorance and remain there, contributing nothing, content and superior forevermore. 33. The whole cosmos is Masonic.
Attention, pay attention. Swallow what you're holding and pay attention to this important message. Professor Kubrick of the Department of Media Studies has instituted a controlled opposition channel. This is like the Flat Earth Society, but in reverse. Go to the channel 1 Minute Debunk and subscribe. Nobody must know you're really flat earthers. Secret message ends.